Very good morning. I am Dr. T. Milton, Dean, Tourism and Hospitality Management from Bharat Institute of Higher Education and Research, Chennai. BSc Catering Science and Hotel Management Program, second year, Food and Beverage Service, third semester. Today we are going to see. The unit number one first is alcoholic beverages. What is meant by alcoholic beverage? You have heard this term alcoholic beverages being served in hotels, restaurants, bars and various other places. Let us see that in detail today. Introduction of alcoholic beverage, definition of alcoholic beverage we will see, followed by that. Classification of alcoholic beverages, production of alcoholic beverages, storage of wines, beers and spirits we will see in this session. The word beverage has been derived from the Latin word bever, meaning rest from work. So bever in Latin, rest from work. When a person continuously is working in the agriculture field or in the industry, after some time he will feel very very tired. He will feel little thirsty. To quench that thirst, you like to drink water or any other beverages. So when you keep on working, there is a fluid loss through perspiration. So one is inclined to drink water or other potable beverages. When you drink these beverages, you will get refreshment. By refreshing, one means the replenishment of fluid loss from the body due to perspiration. When you drink a beverage, stimulation happens. Stimulation results in the increase of heartbeat and blood pressure. Stimulation after drinking is due to the intake of spirits or tea and coffee. When you drink a tea coffee, you feel refreshed. You feel you have more energy now to do the work. Nourishment is provided by the nutrients in the beverages. Most of the beverage supply energy in the form of sugar or alcohol. They provide nutrients like minerals and vitamins. For example, when you drink milk, what happens? It gives calcium. And if you eat citrus fruits, what are the citrus fruits? Like lemon, orange, sweet lime. When you consume this, you get vitamin C. Definition of alcoholic beverages. Alcoholic beverages are potable drinks which have thirst quenching, refreshing, stimulating and nourishing qualities. So alcoholic beverages are potable drinks, of course you can drink, which is thirst quenching. If you are really feeling thirst, when you drink that, it will satisfy your thirst. That is called thirst quenching. Refreshing, when you drink the beverages, it refreshes your body and you feel more energetic. Stimulating means when you drink that, it gives energy and stimulates you to do the work. And nourishing also. What are the nourishments which your body requires? It is in the beverages. So alcohol is obtained by fermenting a liquid containing sugar. Fermentation is a process in which the yeast acts on sugar and converts it to ethanol and gives off carbon dioxide. Pure alcohol, if you can see, it is a colorless, clear liquid with a burning taste. Pure alcohol, it's very difficult to consume. It derives its color from the wood of the cask in which it is matured or from the caramel or vegetable dyes which is added during maturing and bottling. Definition of alcohol. What is meant by alcohol? Alcohol is an odorless liquid obtained through the fermentation of the sugar containing liquid. A potable liquid containing ethyl alcohol or ethanol. So that is the definition of alcohol. It is, alcohol is an odorless liquid. It is obtained by the fermentation of a sugar containing liquid. It can be grapes, it can be sugar cane. It can be various other products also. Alcohol is a word which is derived from the Arabic. Alcohol means a fine powder applied to essences. In those days, this alcohol, a fine powder used by alchemists in Arabia. There are many members of the alcoholic family. but ethyl alcohol is the one which concerns us the most, as it is the principal alcohol to be found in all alcoholic beverages. So from ethyl alcohol only you will get the various alcoholic beverages. So ethyl alcohol is very, very important for us. Any beverage containing 0.55% of alcohol by volume, ABH, to 76% alcohol by volume is considered to be an alcoholic beverage. So what do you mean by alcoholic beverage? You should have at least 0.55% of alcohol to 76% of alcohol is called as an alcoholic beverage. Those with higher than 76% alcohol are known as medicines such as anesthetics. So more than 76% alcohol, it's definitely it's not fit for human beings, and that is used as a medicine during operations. People try to use this anesthesia. Okay, so that type of alcohol is used for anesthetics. Alcoholic beverages, AH effects. What is AH? Alcohol and health. People say that when you drink alcohol, it has got a lot of disadvantages. Of course, anything, any beverage, if you try to drink too much, it has got its disadvantages. If you try to drink in a proper way, it has got its own advantage too. So alcohol and health, if you drink alcohol, it affects the central nervous system and tranquilizes it, thus reducing tension and worries. Initially, if you try to drink more of alcohol, it will try to definitely harm your body. So initially it is a stimulant, later depressant. So when you drink in optimum quantities, definitely it will try to stimulate. If you try to go beyond anything, prescribed level of alcohol, if you try to consume more than that, later it will become a depressant. People try to become addict to alcohol also. So you should be very careful in consuming alcoholic beverages. Alcohol being concentrated source of energy is absorbed by bloodstream from stomach and increases blood pressure for a short while. Effects of alcohol remains in the body for about 24 hours. That's the reason very often you can see that don't drink and drive, they say that. When you drink, you will not be able to drive. Okay? So it is the alcohol will be in your body till 24 hours. You cannot give blood donation. You are not supposed to drive, so you should be very careful in consuming the alcohol. Then let's see classification of alcoholic beverages. So classification of alcohol, there are five different categories, classifications. First is wine, second is beer, third is spirits, fourth one is liquors, and fifth one is cocktails. Wines, I think you all know about wines. Wines are prepared from the freshly harvested grapes. So in the wine, you have different classifications like table wine, sparkling wine, fortified wine, aromatized wine, and so on. So what is meant by table wine? Table wines are the wines which are prepared and it is for the consumption. It has got 10 to 13% of alcohol by volume. Sparkling wine, for example champagne, we will see that little later. Fortified wine are otherwise called as dessert wines or sweet wines, and aromatized wines also we will see in the later session. Beers, there are two different types of classifications, lager and ales, and other classification in the subsequent classes we will try to see that. Spirits, what are spirits? Whiskey, brandy, rum, gin, vodka, tequila. These all are classified as spirits. Liquors. In the spirits, you add little herbs or fruits or flowers or nuts and seeds. Then it is termed as liquors. It is called as digestive stew. Cordial also in some countries they call this. Cocktails. Cocktails are mixture of your alcoholic beverages and other soft drinks is called cocktails. These cocktails can be prepared in the method of shaken method, stirred method, blended method, and built up method. These are the four different ways we can make the cocktails. Shaken method, you try to take the basic drink. It can be whiskey, brandy, rum, gin, and you put it in the cocktail shaker, add the other juices or soft drinks and shake it well. Serve it in the glass. It's called shaken cocktail. Stirred method, you take a glass, add the base spirit like whiskey, brandy, rum, gin, vodka, tequila. Stir it with the help of stirrer and add your juices and other soft drinks and serve it chilled. Blended method, you try to take the spirit, put it in a jar, blender, and then you add the other additives like soft drinks, juices, everything. Put it and blend it. Okay, then you serve it chilled. That is called your blended cocktail. Then built up cocktail is, you just put the basic spirit in a glass, top it with another soft drink and put another juice or another drink, and one over other is called your built up method of making cocktails. We will see all this in detail in the later sessions. Production of alcoholic beverages. Let's see that how alcoholic beverages are produced. Alcoholic beverage is produced by the following methods: fermentation process and distillation process. Fermentation process. Sugar is converted to alcohol and carbon dioxide. This is called your fermentation process of making alcoholic beverages. Another method is called distillation method. Distillation is the process of simultaneous evaporation and condensation of liquid or mixture of liquids to purify them. In this method, there are two types of distillation. One is called pot still method. This is a old method of distillation to make your alcoholic beverages. Another method is called patent still method. That is otherwise called as continuous still or coffee still, and it is named after Aeneas Coffey, who patented in 1831. From this picture, you can see how alcohol is distilled. Okay, alcohol is heated and it is condensed. It is collected as ethyl alcohol. Okay, from the picture we can infer from this. Next, let us see what is meant by fermentation. Fermentation is the process in which sugar is converted to alcohol and carbon dioxide by yeast. This process is a basis for producing all types of alcoholic beverages. So you are supposed to know what is meant by fermentation. Let me repeat it. It is a process in which sugar is converted to alcohol and carbon dioxide by yeast. Okay. Examples of fermented beverages are wine, beer, and cider. The following are necessary for the fermentation to take place. So for the fermentation, you need sugar containing ingredient. It can be your sugar cane, it can be grapes, anything, juniper berries, starch, anything. Then yeast and temperature you need. All these things are very essential for the fermentation process to take on. So from this flow chart, sugar containing ingredient plus yeast, so you get the resultant product as ethyl alcohol and carbon dioxide. Definition of wine. Let's see what is the definition of wine. Wine is an alcoholic beverage obtained from the fermented juice of freshly harvested grapes. It is very important. Every time when you try to learn this definition, please try to know it very clearly. So wine is an alcoholic beverage obtained by the fermented juice of freshly harvested grapes. It is prepared from both white and black grapes. From the white grapes, you can get white wine. From the black grapes, you can get red wine and rose wine, etc. There are many varieties of grapes produced, and not all of them are used in the production of wine. The color, the flavor and the aroma of the wine are largely influenced by the types of the grapes used in the production. If you get a very good quality wine, grapes, from the grapes, you will get a good quality wine. Alcoholic strength or proof, ABV, alcohol by volume. So each and every spirit, you are supposed to know the alcoholic strength, and in the bottle it will be mentioned what is the alcoholic proof or alcoholic strength. So that is very, very essential for a hotel management student. Classification of wines we'll see in detail now. The main classification of wines are on the basis of the grape juice, which is fermented and not distilled. First, let's see, that is table wines. It has got 10 to 14% of alcohol by volume. That is called table wines. Second, sparkling wines. This consists 10 to 13% of ABV, alcohol by volume. Third one is called fortified wines. This contains 16 to 22% of ABV, alcohol by volume. Why it has got more percentage alcohol? Because in the wine, we add brandy also. When you add brandy, the alcoholic percentage of the wine will be increased. So this is called fortified wines or dessert wines. So dessert wines are served along with the desserts. After the main course, the fortified wines or the dessert wines are served, and that contains 16 to 22% of ABV. The fourth one is called aromatized wines. So in the wines, you try to add various products like herbs, barks, spices and roots. It is called as aromatized wines. Usually aromatized wines are consumed after your main course. It consists of 14 to 20% of alcohol by volume. Let us see the production of wines in detail now. Wines are manufactured or produced in different steps. First step is called your viticulture. Viticulture refers to the growing of grapes. How you grow the grape, that is called your viticulture. The grape plant is a creeper which has to be grown on sloping, rocky and chalky soil. Rocky soil is essential to prevent the retention of water. Vintage, usually vintage means the year or place in which wine, especially a wine of very high quality, is produced. While grapes are plucked, okay, this is done manually, often using special scissors. Then the grapes are collected in conical can baskets and taken to the wine press. Wine press, here the grapes are crushed to yield must. Must means what? Fresh grape juice. That is called must. And this wine press is done by four different methods. First, grapes are crushed to yield must, and this grapes are crushed in four different methods, and that methods are broadening, balloon press, manual press and electrically operated press. These are the four press which in which we will try to press the grapes. This step is called wine press. So let's see the four steps now. First, broadening. Broadening, what is meant by broadening? It refers to the crushing of grapes by treading on them. People try to just stamp on the grapes. From that, the juices and the pulp will come out. That will be collected in a shallow tank. Okay. For this, the grapes are placed in shallow tank and the people try to tread on the grapes or walk on the grapes. But of course, they wear the boots with spikes, which prevents the crushing of pips. Pips means your seeds. If you try to use the pips in the making of wine, that is pips, as I told you, it's a seeds, it contains bitter oils, which should be removed. Production of wines, second step, we have seen that we have to see balloon press. The balloon press step in this method, it consists of an expandable balloon, which is fitted in tank, filled with grapes and equipped with an outlet for must. So what they do that, they will try to put the grapes and they'll try to take the balloon and fill with the air. When the balloon expands, it crushes the grapes against the sides of the tank and squeezes out the juice. So this method is called balloon press. So third method is called manual press. The manual press works on the principle of hydraulic pressure. As the central disc descends it crushes the grapes. So manual press, as I told you, it is on the principle of hydraulic pressure. The fourth method is called electrically operated press. This press consists of a roller with a plate fitted all around it. The grapes are crushed between the roller and the plate. So please understand all these four methods in the production of wine. It is called wine press. There are the four different methods we need to employ so that we can crush the grapes. Next step in wine production is the fermentation process. The process of fermentation takes about 3 to 4 days, and it is a result of the action of natural yeast, Saccharomyces ellipsoides, on grape sugar. From white pale grapes, white wine is obtained, and red grapes, white, red and rose wines are obtained. I have already told you, from white wine, white grapes, white wine is obtained, and red wine, so red grape or black grapes, you can get red wine and rose wines also. So next step is your racking. The process of removing pulp and yeast particles from wine is called racking. Here the wines are kept in oak wood casks. Oak wood is a type of wood which helps us to store the wine, and various other process it helps. The wines are kept in oak wood casks with no air space on top, as air oxidizes wine into vinegar for about a month to allow the solids or less to settle at the bottom of the cask. So this process is called racking. The next step is called finning. What is finning? Finning is done in order to remove all suspended particles in wines. It may be done using any of the following three finning materials: egg albumen, using stiffly beaten egg white. So when you take egg, there is egg yolk and egg white. You take egg white, in that you try to stiffly beat it very nicely and add it, so that when you add this, these impurities will come up and we can take it. Icing glass is another way. It is used for clearing the impurities in the wine. Icing glass is derived from the bladder of sturgeon fish. Production of wines, the next step is, after finning, it is refrigeration. Wines are refrigerated in order to avoid bacterial attack. So you need to refrigerate the wines properly. Filtration is the next step. It is done if the wine is not clear enough. So you need to filter it. It is a very slow process and is usually done only in the case of wines meant for domestic market. For that, people for the domestic market, if you are making the wine, this filtration is usually used. Sulfuring. This consists of spraying or gassing the empty casks with sulfur dioxide 15 to 20 days before filling them, and then drying them in the sun. The next step is called maturing. Once the wine is clear and free of impurities, it is filled in black or white oak wood casks and kept for maturing. The maturation period can vary greatly for different types of wines. Champagne, for example, is never matured, while other wines may be matured for 3, 6, 9 months or even for a number of years. The more the years it is matured, the more the taste and aroma and bouquet of the wine will be there, and the more the cost and price of the wine. Blending. It is a process of mixing wines of different years, age and grapes. That is called blending. So when you make a wine from a grape, and when you finish all this process maturing, they will try to take very good other quality of wines and they will try to mix it very well. That is called blending. Bottling. Bottling, it is a process, the final process, they say that. Bottle, it is, wines are bottled in sterilized bottles. Wine bottle is slowly filled and topped with either nitrogen or carbon dioxide to displace any oxygen. If there is any oxygen present, it will try to spoil the wine. So you have to be very careful about that. And during the bottling, they try to take a cork and they try to seal the bottle by the cork. It is capped with the cork. So this is the production of wines process. Next, let us see the storage of wines. Wines are very costly. It involves lot of cumbersome process to make the wines, and of course it is very expensive. Each and every wine bottle is expensive. So that is the reason it has to be stored in the proper method. You need to store wine at the proper temperature. You need to store wine bottles horizontally, and you need to protect wine from the light and vibration. Wine should be stored at proper humidity. You need to store wine in the wine fridge and not in a regular fridge. These are certain small tips. We will see in detail storage of wines in the next slide. There are three important factors in the storage of wines. What are the three important factors? Light, humidity, temperature. So light, if you are having strong direct sunlight, it will affect the wine. So it will react with the wine. So you need to keep it in a dark store, and all wines away from the light, especially direct sunlight and fluorescent fixtures also. Ultraviolet rays can cause wine to be light struck, giving them an unpleasant smell. So you need to be very careful about that. Humidity, some degree of humidity is required in order to keep wines with cork enclosures from drying out. Even when wine bottles are stored on, you need little bit of humidity. Temperature, wine storage temperature should not go over 75, that is 24 degree centigrade. For longer than brief spans of time, at 75 degree wine begins to oxidize. An ideal temperature for storing a varied wine collection is 54 degree Fahrenheit or 12.2 degree centigrade. The next we need to see about beers. Beer is the world's most widely consumed alcoholic beverage. It is the third most popular drink overall after water and tea. People try to drink the water throughout their lifespan. Of course, it is the first drink which is consumed by the human beings in a large quantity. Next is your tea. Okay, then third comes your beer. So you can understand the importance of beer. It is thought by some that it is the oldest fermented beverage. Beer is produced by sacrification of starch and fermentation of the resulting sugar. The starch and sacrification enzymes are often derived from malted cereal grains, most commonly malted barley and malted wheat. Unmalted maize and rice are widely used adjuncts to lighten the flavor because of the lower cost. The preparation of beer is called brewing. Most beer is flavored with hops, which add bitterness and acts as a natural preservative, though the other flavorings such as herbs or fruit may be occasionally included in the production of beer. Beer is a portable alcoholic beverage fermented from the malted barley and flavored with hops. The alcoholic content is between 3% to 5% and is known to be a very refreshing drink, especially in the hot summers. There are different types of beer. Lager beer. Lager beer is distinguished by the fact that the wort is fermented by the bottom fermentation of the yeast. That is, yeast is introduced at the bottom of the fermenting tanks, and then it is stored in refrigerated cellars, that is called lager, at freezing point for a period of 6 months. The process matures the beer. Lager is a German word meaning store. Pilsner lager is a limestone cave of Pilsen in Czechoslovakia. Then another type of beer is called ale. Ale is synonymous with the beer, except that it's a term used for ordinary mild beer, and while better beer is top fermented beer. Porter is a black beer achieved by roasting malt. It is more malty in flavor with less flavoring of hops, but sweeter than stout. Stout, similar to porter in as much as the malt is roasted, it has a strong malt flavor and a sweet taste, but it is heavier and has a strong hop character than porter. This is a name given by Irish and almost similar to porter. Draught beer. It is a freshly gassed beer. Spirit is an alcoholic product that's made from a grain or fruit vegetable derived sugar that's fermented and distilled, yielding a lower water content and higher alcohol by volume. Spirits are the product of distilled fermented beverages such as wine and beer. So if you distill wine and beer, you will get brandy and whiskey respectively. There are several categories of spirits, and biggest ones are gin, rum, whiskey, vodka, tequila and brandy. What differentiates one from another is the base ingredient and the specific production methods used to make it. Those particulars are covered each spirits category individual section. It can be added in the coming months. We'll see that. Here we have a taking broader view of production and the different tools and techniques that we employ to share. So with this, we are coming to the end of this first unit, alcoholic beverage. Thank you.